Hi, welcome to type 2 diabetes number 19. I'm Dr. Vladimir Carvalho, and I'm an endocrinologist. Today, I'm going to answer this question that I've seen a few times. What is the difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes? Now, I'll try to explain to you clearly so that you will never get confused, hopefully. For some of you following this channel, you know that when you eat, your blood sugar goes up, right? But you also know that glucose cannot cross the membrane of the cells. For them to cross the membrane, they need transporters called glucose transporters. But for some cells, like muscle cells and fat cells, the transporters are inside the cells, and they need insulin to come and tell these cells to bring the transporters to the membrane to get glucose. And this insulin, you know that they're made by some cells in your pancreas called beta cells. Now, the food comes, glucose goes up, and beta cells release insulin, and insulin will tell these cells to bring the transporters to the membrane to get glucose. Now, what happens when you have type 1 diabetes? Your immune cells will destroy these beta cells by mistake. They will just come and destroy your beta cells that is supposed to make insulin that should come and tell your cells to get glucose. Now, this I say by mistake because your immune system is supposed to know all the cells in your body. They are supposed to come here and say, hey, beta cells, how you doing? And you know, they go like, we're doing well, we're working, making insulin. But somehow they come and they look at beta cells and they go like, who are you? And start destroying them. So for these people, they have no beta cells that are supposed to make insulin. So that means they have no insulin, which means they have no one to come and tell the cells that they need to come and get glucose. So glucose will stay in the blood. And this is not nice because your immune system is supposed to destroy other things that are trying to invade your body, like, you know, the thing that has been going on for the past 2 or 3 years. Yeah, your immune system is supposed to kill stuff like that. But for some unknown reasons, they kill your beta cells by mistake. Now, until now, we're not very sure why they do that. You know, there's some studies that say that maybe you have an infection before, a viral infection or something, and then your immune system gets activated to fight it and then later start fighting your beta cells instead. And some say that it's just a malfunctioning of your immune system. And some others say genetics and, you know, different ideas. But no one knows for sure why it happens to some people. But the point is your cells are destroyed and they can't make insulin. So you can remember that for type 1 diabetes, you have one problem. Your cells are destroyed and they can't make insulin. Now, when we're talking about type 2 diabetes, that's a different story. You know, type 2 diabetes is a metabolic disorder caused mainly by lifestyle. Now, okay, I think I should change this. Yeah, because type 2 diabetes is the one that's caused by lifestyle. For type 1, it doesn't matter too much what you eat because, as I said, it's your immune system making mistakes. But for type 2 diabetes, it's mostly because of lifestyle. Now, with this modern life where we have abundance of food, all kinds of food, you know, especially this refined stuff, and very low levels of physical activity, especially in some countries, you know, this is a fact. Now, when we keep putting all this glucose inside our body and blood sugar keeps rising, and because we're not working too much like back in the days, our muscle cells don't need to take all those glucose. And all this glucose will make your pancreas release a lot of insulin, will force your beta cells to release a lot of insulin to put this glucose inside the fat cell. Insulin will come and attach to the insulin receptors. The transporters will come and take glucose inside the cell. Now, if we keep doing that for a long time, these cells will start to resist insulin. Some of them, when insulin comes and attaches, nothing will happen. Now, if insulin is not working well, what we call insulin resistance, when your cells are resisting insulin, then your pancreas has to work even harder to release more insulin so that they can put them inside by force. So these beta cells, your beta cells of the pancreas, will basically have to overwork, work day and night. Well, they always work day and night, but they have to overwork to release even more insulin. But the problem is that with time, after years of overworking, some of these beta cells will also start to die, and some will become dysfunctional. And you will have not enough beta cells to make insulin to come here and tell these cells to come and get glucose. That's why for most people with type 2 diabetes, at the time of diagnosis, about half of these beta cells, half of the beta cell function is gone. So type 1 diabetes, you have one problem. Your beta cells are gone because of your immune system, nothing more. For type 2 diabetes, you have two problems, insulin resistance and beta cell dysfunction. Now, maybe I can show you how islets look like, because we analyzed thousands of islets. And this is a section of the pancreas. And inside your pancreas, there are some cluster of cells called islets. For example, this is one islet. And the beta cells are supposed to be inside here. And this is another one. And these ones look normal. This is how a normal islet look like. You know, they're almost round. And they're very different from the exocrine part of the pancreas. But let me show you, for if you are obese, how your pancreas might look like. This is a pancreas that is full of fat. Look, these white, you know, round things are all fat that is inside the pancreas. And for them, look at how the islets look like. This one was stained for muscle that shows the amount of collagen, amount of scars inside your islet. So all these blue that you can see are scars. For example, this is supposed to be an islet. I showed you that they're supposed to be round, and inside looks like this when you stain for muscle. But look at this one. All these ones are scars inside your islet. This is how islets tend to look like when the pancreas has been overworking for too long. You know, at some point, they will not be able to keep up. Now, let's get back. Maybe another day, I'll show you how we can recognize insulin and glucagon and some other cells in your islet, and maybe some other things that we do in the lab. But, you know, I'm not sure what I can and cannot show on YouTube. Now, with this understanding, let's think about how we can recognize someone with type 1 or type 2 diabetes. If we look for antibodies that your immune system makes to come and destroy these beta cells, in which of these do you think we can find them? Type 1 or type 2 diabetes? Of course, type 1 diabetes, because your immune system destroys the beta cells. They make antibodies that can attach to beta cells or insulin and some other proteins inside and attack them. So you can find some antibodies that cause type 1 diabetes, but not type 2 diabetes. Now, let's think about another one. Now, for these two, which one do you think is more likely to be overweight? You know, okay, I think, you can look at the picture. But let's say you don't look at this picture. Which one do you think is more likely to be overweight? Of course, type 2 diabetes. Because I said, this is a lifestyle disease. And most people have to be overweight to have type 2 diabetes. At the time of diagnosis of type 2 diabetes, most people will have a BMI of more than 30, you know, especially in rich countries. Now, not everyone, but most people will have a BMI more than 30 at the time of diagnosis of type 2 diabetes. So that means that it has a lot to do with your weight, while type 1 diabetes has nothing to do with your weight and how you live your lifestyle. Another one, which one of these two do you think blood sugar tends to be the highest when they come to the hospital? Of course, type 1 diabetes, because they don't have insulin. The body is not producing any insulin, so all this glucose will stay here. You know, while type 2 diabetes, the insulin is not working well and there is some beta cell dysfunction, but you still have some insulin. But for people with type 1 diabetes, your beta cells are destroyed and glucose keeps rising. And a lot of people with type 1 diabetes, when they come to the hospital, they are in a serious condition. Some of them come with, you know, ketoacidosis, some with very high blood sugar, and, you know, some even in coma sometimes. Now, let's go to another one. Number four, which one do you think is more likely to happen early in life? Type 1 or type 2? Type 1 diabetes. Because, as I said, your immune system is making mistakes. And when you're young, your immune system is still learning. So they're more likely to make mistakes. And then type 2 diabetes, as I told you, is a lifestyle disease. So first, you have to live a lifestyle where you can, you know, reach some levels, maybe almost like this one. Then you will have type 2 diabetes. So it takes a long time. And number five, let's say you do a C-peptide test. This is a test that will tell you how much insulin your body is still producing. Maybe one day I will talk about it. So which one do you think will be higher? Of course, type 2 diabetes, because they still have some insulin. So people with type 1 diabetes, their C-peptide levels tend to be very low. And look at this C-peptide test. We can also ask another question. Which one of these two has to take insulin? Type 1, because they are not making any. So they have to take insulin. But for type 2 diabetes, a lot of people, especially early or at the middle stage of type 2 diabetes, they can manage their blood sugar with lifestyle changes. That's why when we talk about type 2 diabetes, you see a lot of channels talking about vegan diet, you know, fasting, keto diet, low carb diet, you know, all kinds of diet to help you control your blood sugar or even reverse your diabetes. Some people can reverse their type 2 diabetes, but you never see anyone talking about reversing type 1 diabetes because it's not possible. It has nothing to do with the food you eat. But type 2, because it has to do with your lifestyle, you can reverse it. I've seen a lot of people doing that. But type 1 diabetes, you cannot talk about reversing it. But you should not lose hope if you have type 1 diabetes, because in the future, there will be a cure for type 1 diabetes. Because as I said, your immune system is destroying your beta cells. So we just need to put them back. And now, to make some other cells change to beta cells or to cells that produce insulin is easy. Some good labs, you know, in some countries can do that like in less than an hour, you know, to make some other cells produce insulin. But the problem is how we can put them inside your body and hide them in a way that your immune system will not go back and destroy them again, you know. So, but this one will come. I think in the future, you will have cure for type 1 diabetes. If I think about something else, maybe I'll just put it on the screen. So, type 1, one problem, your immune system destroys your beta cells. You don't have them. They can't make insulin to tell your cells to come and get glucose. Glucose stays in your blood. For type 2, we have first insulin resistance because of the lifestyle that we're living now. Then your beta cells have to overwork until some of the beta cells die or get dysfunctional. And that's problem number 2. So insulin resistance and beta cell dysfunction. Have a blessed week. Bye.